These were the chiefs of David's mighty warriors. They, together with all Israel, gave his kingship strong support to extend it over the whole land, as the Lord had promised. This is the list of David's mighty warriors. Jashobeam, a Hakmonite, was chief of the officers. He raised his spear against 300 men, whom he killed in one encounter. Next to him was Eleazar, son of Dodai, the Ahohite, one of the three mighty warriors. He was with David at Pas Dammim when the Philistines gathered there for battle, at a place where there was a field full of barley. The troops fled from the Philistines, but they took their stand in the middle of the field. They defended it and struck the Philistines down, and the Lord brought about a great victory. 3 of the 30 chiefs came down to David, to the rock at the cave of Adullam, while a band of Philistines was encamped in the valley of Rephaim. At that time, David was in the stronghold, and the Philistine garrison was at Bethlehem. David longed for water and said,
"Oh, that someone would get me a drink of water from the well near the gate of Bethlehem."
So the 3 broke through the Philistine lines, drew water from the well near the gate of Bethlehem, and carried it back to David. But he refused to drink it. Instead, he poured it out to the Lord.
"God forbid that I should do this," he said. "Should I drink the blood of these men who went at the risk of their lives?"
Because they risked their lives to bring it back, David would not drink it. Such were the exploits of the 3 mighty warriors. Abishai, the brother of Joab, was chief of the 3. He raised his spear against 300 men whom he killed, and so he became as famous as the 3. He was doubly honored above the 3, and became their commander, even though he was not included among them. Benaiah, son of Jehoiada, a valiant fighter from Kabzeel, performed great exploits. He struck down Moab's 2 mightiest warriors. He also went down into a pit on a snowy day and killed a lion. And he struck down an Egyptian who was 5 cubits tall. Although the Egyptian had a spear like a weaver's rod in his hand, Benaiah went against him with a club. He snatched the spear from the Egyptian's hand and killed him with his own spear. Such were the exploits of Benaiah, son of Jehoiada. He too was as famous as the 3 mighty warriors. He was held in greater honor than any of the 30, but he was not included among the 3, and David put him in charge of his bodyguard. The mighty warriors were Asahel, the brother of Joab, Elhanan, son of Dodo from Bethlehem, Shamoth the Hararite, Helez the Palanite, Ira, son of Ikesh from Tekoa, Abiezer from Anathoth, Sibekai the Hushathite, Ilai the Ahohite, Maharai the Netophathite, Helad son of Baana the Netophathite, Ithai son of Rabbi from Gibeah in Benjamin, Benaiah the Parathonite, Hurai from the ravines of Gaash, Abiel the Arbathite, Asmaveth the Baharumite, Eliaba the Shalbonite, the sons of Hashem the Gizanite, Jonathan son of Shagai the Hararite, Ahayam son of Sakar the Hararite, Eliphal son of Ur, Hefer the Mekerethite, Ahijah the Pelonite, Hezro the Carmelite, Naarai son of Ezbai, Joel the brother of Nathan, Mibhar son of Hagri, Zelek the Ammonite, Naharai the Berethite, the armor bearer of Joab son of Zeruiah, Ira the Ithrite, Gareb the Ithrite, Uriah the Hittite, Zabad son of Alai, Adina son of Shiza the Reubenite, who was chief of the Reubenites, and the 30 with him, Hanan son of Maaka, Josaphat the Mithnite, Uzziah the Ashtarathite, Shama and Jael the sons of Hotham, the Aroerite, Jediel son of Shimri, his brother Johah the Tizite, Eliel the Mahavite, Jeribai and Josaviah the sons of Elnaam, Ithna the Moabite, Eliel, Obed and Jaziel, the Mezobite,